I'm Neha Agarwalla, coach and co-owner at 303 Crossfit Drive, and I'm here to change people's lives. So we started 303 3.5 years ago. When I say we, I mean my partner Vishisht Kapoor and I. Vishisht was my coach actually before we started 303, and I really wanted to change people's lives, open my own space, and I heard that he wanted to do the same. So we started talking about it. And I know that, and my father really actually scared me. He was like, partnerships are scary, you know, they usually fall apart. Are you sure you want to partner up with someone? Do it by yourself. And I was a little scared about that. But then when I spoke to Vish, I realized that we're actually, and I've realized this more over the last 3.5 years, is that we actually work really, really well together, because I'm more of like a hands-on, get things done person, but I can also be a control freak. Whereas Vish is more calm, relaxed, and he's extremely knowledgeable about CrossFit and everything. So I think we work really well together, because he can come up with great ideas and stuff, and I'm amazing at executing them, so it becomes really synergetic. My first day when I walked into a CrossFit gym, I just had the same goal as most other people. I wanted to be thin, I wanted to lose weight. So someone told me CrossFit is really fun, try it out. So I walked into the gym, and there was weightlifting involved, lots of body weight workouts also involved. And I just had so much fun. And I was like, okay, you know what, I want to try this again. And so I went back, and since that day to today, there's never been a day that I haven't done CrossFit. And I just loved it so much that my goals changed over time. You know, I wanted to be thin and I just wanted to look good. And now I want to be strong, I want to be fitter, I want to be better every single day. And I actually see the same thing in my members, you know. Like even over time, even they walk in with the same thing that, you know, I have a tummy, I want to make my thighs thinner. And it's hard to explain to them how their goals are going to change. But as they just start having fun, they stop worrying about these little things. Their goals just become a lot higher than that. I understand that when women imagine themselves weightlifting, they have this weird notion that 3 or 4 days into weightlifting, they're suddenly going to have these bulky, huge muscles. And I think partly the fitness industry is also to blame for that, because a lot of extremely competitive athletes, maybe CrossFitters, bodybuilders, a lot of the entire elite level, some of them are on performance enhancing drugs. They have been caught, which means that the level of muscle they build is abnormal, because even their hormone levels are completely different from normal people. Right now, I've been doing CrossFit for 6 years, right? And I've been doing a lot of weightlifting very, very regularly. I eat a lot of protein, and still I haven't gotten ridiculously muscular. So it's a big myth in your head. And second of all, I think that women are a little scared that they look a particular way and then people won't approve of it, like men won't find them pretty. First of all, why do you want to be with someone who's going to make you limit your potential and make you not look a particular way just because they don't like it? That's really sad. And second of all, like weightlifting makes you feel so good and so confident about yourself that you'll stop worrying about such people in your life. Like you'll actually push them out, you'll have better people in your life, you'll make friends at your CrossFit gym, at your community, who will be so encouraging, you won't need such kind of negative people in your life anymore. I was a new coach and I have to coach a class of boys who have been like maybe training longer than me. So you do feel like they don't take you as seriously. But I feel like that's also partly because I was doubting myself. I wasn't sure of my own abilities. But over the last 3.5 years, I focused, I've gained a lot more knowledge, I've become a lot more competent at my job. And I don't feel that way anymore. You know, I feel like people take me a lot more seriously. It's not about a boy or a girl, it's about how much you really know. I face sexism still on Instagram sometimes. You know, people pass mean comments about how girls shouldn't be lifting and how I look like a man or I won't be able to have children and funny things like that. But honestly, I've always just laughed at that. I very, very rarely take it seriously, because honestly, I don't know these people. These are people sitting at home trying to be virtual heroes on their phones. Why would I give attention to something like that? Like, I have enough people in my life who are encouraging me, enough supportive people. So I just find it funny. I just joke around with these trollers and I really don't get involved in it. The worst, I think, is just one of those sexist comments about how I can't have children anymore because I've probably got so much testosterone in my body or something. I actually didn't respond to it, but I had like 50 other people respond on my behalf on Instagram. I can't single out a best comment. I've had a lot of people being super appreciative of what I do, and people are just very encouraging in general. There are more encouraging people than discouraging people. So you have some serious masculinity issues. You're obviously insecure of yourself, so maybe you need to work on that. I'd be super excited to work with her. Like, I have some women like that in my gym and I love training them because it's just so exciting to see girls that actually want to live up to their potential. Just keep educating yourself. Keep building your knowledge. I think that's something people get very lazy about. It's just, no matter what point you reach in your career, never stop studying, never stop trying to learn new things. I would say stop identifying yourself constantly as a woman, and because sometimes we pull ourselves down in that situation. You're just a person trying to do something. Just like anybody else, you have to work hard, you have to push yourself. Of course, you might have to push yourself a little more because people might not take you that seriously, especially in a field like fitness. But I don't see how, if you keep going at it, how you won't get better.